belong to Hallelujah. Elijah knew his identity. Praise the Lord. Do you know that Elijah knew his identity? Praise God. Daniel 11 verse 32. Elijah told all the people, let's go to Mount Carmel. Let's go and see who God will be serving. If it's Baal, we will serve him. If it is God, Daniel chapter 11, verse 32. Yeah, I said verse B. That's why I said part B. Yeah, read part B.
The people that know their God shall be strong and do exploits.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
What does the Bible say? The people who are? Who know their God? They shall be strong.
And they shall do exploits.
And they shall do exploits. The people who know?
The
people, that means the people who belong to God. They shall be strong and do exploits. If you know God, you'll be strong. Even when news comes from all over, even from White House, from wherever, bad news, because everywhere is bad news. Everywhere is bad news. Even from Kenya, bad news. From Asia, bad news. But I want to tell you, if you know your God, you'll be strong and you'll do exploits. You stand for your God at all times. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Those who know their God, they shall be strong and they shall do exploit.
Amen.
You are going to do exploit if you know yourself.
Amen.
In the place of work, you are not an ordinary woman. I don't know who said here that we are not ordinary people.
Yes.
Somebody was testifying and said that.
Yes.
You are not ordinary. It is evangelist. She said, we are not ordinary people.
It was Pastor.
Is it Pastor? Praise the Lord, yeah. He said, we are not ordinary.
Yes.
We've been assigned to be extraordinary people to do extraordinary things.
Amen.
I was reading the book of the late Bishop Idahosa, and he was saying how God helped him to realize and understand that he was not a man like other men.
Amen.
And he decided to be doing things that other men are not doing. He started even fighting with the greatest witches in Nigeria.
Amen.
When they planned a meeting, they said, we are bringing a meeting in Benin City. He said, if I am a prophet of God, you are now going to have a meeting in Benin City.
Amen.
It was addressed in the news, and there was a fight between him and the witches. All the witches of the world had to gather in Benin City. And they were called in the newsroom, and they were interviewed. And this man was asking, are you going to do the meeting? He said, yes. And now the other one in the house at his time, he's saying, there shall not be a meeting of witches in Benin City if I be the man of God.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
When the meeting was being prepared, before 2 weeks, this man went to the office of the Archbishop and said, I want you to pray for me and I want to give my life to God. I want you to give me a Bible. Hallelujah.
Yes.
And there was no meeting in Benin. Those who know their God, they'll be mighty, strong, and to exploit.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Don't worry because of the witches who are coming at the back of your bedroom.
Jesus.
Those spams that are making noises being sent by the devil. Tell them, those owls. You know owls, they are bad, bad. They're bad bads. They are bad bads. They come to say somebody is going to die. You know, many, many years we believe that when an owl cried, if it cries this side, on the other side, somebody will die. And it happened.
Mm-hmm.
Even dogs have some.
Yes.
But all these witches and whatever, we are not going to die before time in the name of Jesus. Even witches can even come in your house wearing whatever they are wearing. And say in Jesus, and say, we are going to finish you. Let me tell you, let them just come, the fire will burn them.
Yes.
Especially this girl, the witches cannot touch it.
Yes.
They cannot touch it. They will try to come with their witches, with their assignment, before the service is over, then we leave the place. Because there is fire.
Yes,
yes, there is fire. Hallelujah.
Yes.
There is fire. One thing I know about this church, we have a big God.
Yes.
We may not have everything that other people are having, but we have a big God who takes care of us because we belong to Him. Those people who know their God, they will be strong and do exploit. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. We need to know who we are. We belong to a mighty God. We belong to a rich God. I may not be having billions today, but if I have an assignment of a billion, I will get it from my Father.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Amen. You know, some people think that being rich is to be having a lot of money. Being rich is to be doing what is supposed to be done every day.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
When God is sending, like when we were going to Kenya, you know what? God just brought the money for the assignment that we were going for. And we had enough money, and everything was accomplished. And people may think we called a harambee. Did we call any harambee here?
No.
We didn't call anybody to raise money. Just God brought it in His own ways. Even raising money, I don't say it's bad because we are going to raise money to mission. But I'm telling you that being rich is doing what you're supposed to do every day, and you're not struggling.
Yes.
If you're supposed to pay your car bill, you don't need to struggle. Pay your car bill 500 every month comfortably in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
That is being rich.
Amen.
Paying your mortgage in time.
Amen.
That is being rich.
Oh, yes.
Paying your rent every month.
Yes.
If you're struggling paying your rent, let's pray for you.
Amen.
It's not good for us to struggle paying rent.
Mm-hmm.
God needs to give us more than enough.
Amen.
It is true. Because we know our God, we don't need to struggle paying our rent or paying our bills. We don't need to struggle paying the debts of people. That you, when you take somebody's money, you struggle until you start hiding. It's poverty. We cast it out.
In
Jesus' name. We need, when you give me your 500, if I say it's a month, I need by month or 3 weeks, I tell you, my brother, this is the money you gave me. Because giving out money to somebody is not a sin. But we need to pay back.
True.
And I'm praying that this church will have a person who will be having a company to be loaning money.
In the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
We come to your office and people go to the money tree.
Amen.
Let me tell you, one day I went to the money tree. I was in need of 1,000. I was so broke and I wanted 1,000. Let me tell you the things they told me. The members they gave me, I didn't feel half of it. And I felt, after feeling all this, will I be given this money? So I went to them and asked a question. When I asked a question, she said, oh, you don't qualify. So I said, God is good that I didn't feel all this. There were like 25 pages. You feel them. I pray that God is going to give us one person in this church that to have that company, that will be loaning, just taking people's ID and a paycheck, a piece of a check, just that, and tell people, when you get your paycheck, put this money in the bank. And nobody will take your money in Jesus' name.
Amen.
How many people want to do that business?
Thank you, Jesus.
May the Lord listen to us in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Instead of going to people, they ask you, you are what? You are credit. You know, especially when you hear credit, you feel to go down. Your knees lack power. Because credit, like me, many I have credit, like. But let me tell you, time is coming when God is opening doors that you don't need a credit. You only need to give your identity, because identity is number one. We say it is number one.
Yes.
Then you give a check to see, to prove that these 2 weeks you promised you are going to pay this money. You have given a check that the owner will put it in the bank. I call this anointing to come down in the name of Jesus.
Yes.
God, may you bless one person or two or three in this place that we are going to open that office. The office. You know, the Bible tells us in the book of Deuteronomy that you shall lend to many.
Yes.
And you shall not borrow.
Amen.
Is it the word of God?
Yes.
Is it for those who love the Lord?
Yes.
And is it not for those who are called according to His purpose?
Yes.
Why don't we grab it and say, I am a lender.
Yes.
I am a lender. I will lend to nations. When we open that office, Spanish will come.
Amen.
Filipinos will come.
Amen.
The word will fulfill.
Yes.
You will lead to nations.
Amen.
You know, people think when we talk about nations, it's going to Israel, China. And no, we are in the land where all nations, we can serve all nations in one office here.
Yes.
When Filipino come, when Congolese come, when a Nigerian come, when somebody from Kenya come, you are serving all nations. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
When we know who we are, when we know who we belong to, we will not fear.
Yes. Yes. Amen.
And you know what? When you understand your area in life, when you understand God, who God is in your life, you not fear about degrees. You know, in Tabernacle, I think we don't have a degree, and I'm praying that we have them. But even before we have them, let us exercise our faith to become great and mighty men and women.
In the name of Jesus. Amen.
It is not only a degree. It's good to have a degree. But because we don't have, like me, I'm not looking for one because I cannot do it. But I know I have a God who can lift me than those who have PhDs.
Amen.
Because when you know your God, you'll be strong and do exploit.
Amen.
It's not about education, it's about faith.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
I was mentioning about Elijah. Elijah said, go and tell these people to come. Those prophets, 450 prophets of Baal.
Yeah.
And all the people of Israel, he said, we don't need to struggle any more time. Hatufai kupigana tena, twendeni mlimani tukajue Mungu wa kweli ni nani. And he was alone. Hallelujah.
Amen.
He went to the mountain. He told them, I give you the first time to try to call your God.
Mm-hmm.
They took the whole day. But what does the Bible say? When he came to the altar, hallelujah.
Amen.
He started worshiping, praying in the tongues.
Yeah.
He started calling the name of God.
Yeah.
He started practicing his faith. He said, God, yeah. God of heaven, may you answer me.
Yeah.
The Bible says, God answered with fire.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
And when he went up, he said, just make deep trenches and put water so that you not say it was dry. That's why the fire came.
Mm-hmm.
You know what? Elijah knew his God.
Yes.
And he knew who he was.
Yes.
The same to Joshua. It reached somewhere and Joshua said, oh my goodness, what is the time? He looked at the watch and said, it's almost 3 p.m. or 4 p.m. and we are still yet not finished with the battle. He said, let this sun stand still. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Joshua knew who he was.
Amen.
Today we don't have those people who have faith who can say, in Jesus' name, I stop this nonsense in my company.
Amen.
I stop this gazing. He said gazing, whatever it is.
Yeah, yeah.
I stop it in Jesus' name.
Yeah, yeah.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
You see people worshiping idols and you say it's okay. And you are very happy eating and drinking.
Uh-huh.
You need to fast and say in Jesus' name. This Amen. Stuff should not be done wherever I am.
Amen.
In my company. You are there for a reason.
Oh, yes.
To stop lesbian sin.
Amen.
To stop evil worship. Some people, they are very happy even. They say, you know, near the Mohanoku. It's true, you are born again. But Elijah did not say, I'm born again. He said, yes, I'm going to prove my God. Let us go to Mount Carmel.
Yeah.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Some of us, we just sit down and say, it's okay. Even they worship the idols. Even they put some on your clothes. Even they put some on your food and you say, it's okay. It is not okay. Tell the devil, enough is enough. I will not eat the food of the demons.
Oh, yes.
Hallelujah.
Oh, yeah.
It is time to say, enough is enough, devil. There is a border between me and you.
Amen.
Whether you are employed or not, you need to know your ground.
Amen.
Those who know their God, they will be strong and to exploit.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
As I finish, I want us to read the book of 1 Peter 2, verse 9. I'm finishing with that verse so that we can pray in Jesus' name. Hallelujah.
Amen.
We are mighty people when we recognize our identity. Our daddy is the richest person in the earth. No amen here.
Amen.
Thank you, Jesus, because my father is the richest one.
Amen.
The greatest of the greatest.
Yes.
The billionaire of the billionaires.
Yes.
He owned trillions and trillions of dollars.
Yes.
We were talking another day with evangelist and Yvonne, and they were saying how, I don't know what they were writing, and they were saying, I need to own trillions. And I say, amen. Me too. I need to own trillions.
Mm-hmm.
Amen.
Amen.
Some people desire something little. They say, you know what? If it is God giving you, go for the biggest one.
Amen.
Even if you have a football or place inside there, let us come and play football there.
Amen.
For the glory of God.
Amen.
Get the best from the Father.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
I'm waiting for somebody to read there so that we can finish.
1 Peter 2, verse 9.
But you are a chosen people,
mm-hmm.
a royal priesthood, mm-hmm. a holy nation, a people belonging to God.
Amen.
That you may declare the praises of him who called you out of darkness into his wonderful light.
I wanted that verse that says you are a people of God.
Mm-hmm.
You are royal priesthood, holy nation. Why don't we stand and read that verse together? Everybody open your Bible wherever it is. 1 Peter 2 verse 9. It doesn't matter the version you have. If you, and give us time, those who are not there. Apostle tells us to say, help me, God. I think I need to be helped. 1 Peter chapter 2 and verse 9. Hallelujah. Okay, let us go. 1, 2, 3.
But you are a chosen generation, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, his own special people,
that you may proclaim the praises of him who called you out of the darkness into his marvelous light.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
But you are a chosen generation, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, his special people, that you may proclaim the praises of him who called you out of darkness into his marvelous light.
Amen.
That word is enough for you this whole year. Amen. The remaining of these 6 months ahead of us, Amen. You can just know that I'm royal priesthood, I am a holy nation, chosen generation, don't let the devil to kiss you.
Amen.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Some people, they are friends with the devil, even they are hugged by the devil and say it's okay. Even they receive a kiss from the devil, they say it's okay. He cannot kiss me. I cannot give the devil my hug. I cannot give the devil my hand to shake him. I cannot. He's my enemy.
Amen.
Be an enemy of the devil.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Amen. Don't entertain demonic things. You are a born again Christian. You are bought at a price.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
You are bought at a price. Take care of your salvation.
Amen.
Take care of your holiness.
Amen.
Young girls, you need to be righteous and holy.
Oh, yeah.
Praise God.
Amen.
Young people, don't let the devil to pray around with you by buying clothes from Ross, by buying lunch from Mongolians. What do we call it? Evangelist Maureen took me to Mongolia. What is it called, Maureen?
Mongolian grill.
Don't let anybody just take you for lunch for nothing. To misuse you. You are royal priesthood.
Amen.
Wait upon Jesus.
Amen.
Your man who will be buying lunch for you is coming.
Amen.
He's coming.
Amen.
Wait and see. He's coming.
Amen.
Reverend Catherine read the word for us before we started.
Mm-hmm.
In the book of Isaiah. Those who wait upon the Lord,
yes.
They shall renew their strength.
Yes.
They shall mount up like eagles. Your time to mount up like an eagle is coming.
Amen.
Your time for people to see you up there. They'll be looking up, not down.
Amen.
Now they are looking you down. But time is coming when they will lift their eyes to see you.
Amen.
There will be no other level for them to see you until they do like this.
Amen.
Because you are elevated by God.
Amen.
Tell your neighbor, your time of elevation is now.
Amen.
And you are going to be possessed by God that everybody will know. You know, sometimes people pretend that they don't know God is blessing you. They will not pretend this time. Even those enemies, those who talked about up and about them of praise, they will say, we didn't know you have a God. They will come and testify crying here.
Amen.
They are coming crying and saying, we didn't know you have a God. We thought you are just playing around.
Amen.
Let's stand firm and wait and see what God is doing.
Amen.
Those who laughed at you in the neighborhood, they will come and ask you, are you the same lady who used to sit under me when we were in Lakewood apartment? Are you the one? You tell them, I'm the one. But this time, I'm royal priesthood.
Amen.
I'm a royal priesthood.
Amen.
I'm a holy nation.
Amen.
I'm a chosen generation.
Amen.
I'm not just a woman.
Yes.
Let the devil know that you are not just a woman.
Amen.
I saw another thing in the WhatsApp that says, those who fear God, when they rise up, demons know.
Yes.
They are rising up.
Yes.
When you're going to the bathroom, demons know. You are going to the bathroom. But there are some people, they stay with the demons in the house, they feed the demons there. And they are okay, they sleep there with the demons. And the demons, they sing in their houses, they enjoy. You don't need to entertain the demons, they need to flee away from you.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Let the devil get out, get thee behind me, Satan. will not take it. I'm not here to exchange my salvation because I'm in the United States. I better go back to Kenya with Jesus.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Remember, God said to the children of Israel, when you go to that land, do not forget where you have come from. Today, God is talking to us. We have come from Africa. Some of us fasted, dry fasting 7 days, 20 days. And we said, God, help us to go to U.S. When we came here, we forgot our God. May God help us. It's time to go back to our God. It's time to go back to the levels that the Lord is calling us. We read that those people who are called by the name of the Lord, when they call him, he will answer them.
Amen.
I want us to call upon the name of our Lord. We need restoration. We need to realize that we are special people. We are peculiar. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Do you know that word is very powerful? Peculiar person. You are a peculiar person. Hallelujah. Peculiar person.